The 8th folder in your resource tree is called Timelines. You can create a new timeline by either clicking on the Resource button on your menu bar, selecting Create Timeline, which is also Shift-Control-T, or you can right-click on the Timelines folder in your resource tree and click on Create Timeline. Once you do, you'll be greeted with a Timeline Properties window for your new timeline. As with all resources, now is a great time to name your resource. I'm sure by now you know that you should use a prefix for the name of your resource. You can use whatever works for you. Personally, I use TML underscore and then the name of my timeline. You'll notice here that this window bears a striking resemblance to the objects window, at least on the middle to right side. Instead of an events panel, you have a panel called Moments. The reason for this is a timeline is just a series of alarm triggers. The ultimate goal of a timeline is to kind of create a list of things you want an object to do and at what time, or at what moment. Moments are calculated in steps. Let's go ahead now and create some moments. Below your name, you'll find a bunch of buttons. The first one is Add. If you click on it, you'll get a window that says Adding a Moment. Here you can indicate at what step you want this first moment to happen. The zero moment of this timeline will happen depending on where you've placed it in your object. If this timeline starts when your object is created, that's the zero moment. However, this could also happen when the room starts, or when an enemy dies, or when your score is exactly a million. It really doesn't matter, but whenever you tell this timeline to start, that's the zero moment. Then the timeline will start ticking in steps. So let's just say our first moment happens at zero. Now you've created something similar to an event for an object. So what we're saying is, at step zero, something happens. Like an action, you have a bunch of tabs on the right side of different things you can do for drag and drop. However, for my lessons, we're just going to use code. So all you need to do is click on the Control tab, go to the third section called Code, and that first drag and drop icon, that page, execute code, that's the one you want to drag into actions. Now you'll get a code editor window. Of course, we haven't covered code yet, so we won't actually do anything here right now. Just close that code window, and let's go back to working with our moments. So let's just create a few more moments, arbitrarily. Let's say that our next moment happens 2 seconds later, which is 30 times 2, or 60. So something will happen at step 60, or 2 seconds later. Let's just say something happens, I don't know, every 2 seconds. So our next moment would be 120, and we'll add another moment at 180. And let's just say that's good enough for now. Now that we have some moments, we can learn what all these other buttons do. The button below Add is Delete. It doesn't just simply delete the moment you have highlighted. If you click on it, you'll be presented with a window. From here, you can actually delete moments from a range till a range. So from moment and till moment. Let's say we selected from moment 60 till moment 180. If we did that, moment 60, 120, and 180 would all be deleted. Why don't you type that in, and let's click on OK. Now you can see they're all gone. The unfortunate part is you cannot control Z this, so they're gone, and that's it. You could, however, always close this window and not save any changes by clicking on the X at the top right of the window. But since we're learning, let's just add them again. Now that we have step 0, 60, 120, and 180 again, let's try some more buttons. To the right of Add, we have a button called Change. If we click on it, we'll get a window called Changing a Moment. We have a text field called Indicate a New Moment. It'll automatically input the time for the moment we already have highlighted. From here, we can type in a new number. And then when you click OK, you'll see that that step has changed its position based on the new number. If you type in the same number as another step, GameMaker should tell you that that step already exists and will not let you do that. Below Change, you'll find a button called Clear. This will actually just clear all of your moments and delete everything as if you're starting from scratch. Since it is an extreme button, a confirmation window will pop up. Below the four buttons I just mentioned, you'll find Shift. Shift is a very interesting button. If you click on it, you'll get a Shift Moments window. You'll have three fields for inputting text. The first field is from moment, and the second field is till moment. What you're doing is selecting a range of steps you wish to affect. For instance, let's choose from moment 0 till moment 60. And what we're going to do for the third field is select how we're going to change those steps. Let's type in the number 240. You'll now notice that everything was increased by 240. So 0 is now 240, and the rest of the values that were inside that range have also been increased by 240. Since we did not include step 120 and 180, those are left unaffected. And 120 is now the first moment. This is just a simple way to move your steps around without having to constantly click the change button. The button on the right side of shift is duplicate. If you click on it, you get a window for duplicate moments. You'll find the same three text fields here, from moment, till moment, to moment. Once again, you're selecting a range of moments. But instead of shifting those moments to a new value, you're duplicating these moments to a new value. It's like highlighting a bunch of files, hitting Ctrl-C to copy, and then hitting Ctrl-V to paste. It's a good way to just repeat a bunch of moments over and over again if you need to. The button below Shift is Spread. If you click on the Spread button, you'll get a Spread Moments window. Once again, you'll get three fields. However, the third one is different. You still have Front Moment and Till Moment to select your range of moments, but the third field is now called Percentage, which is defaulted at 100. This may be a little complicated to understand, so let's just break into something really simple. Let's say our From Moment is 0, and our Till Moment is 4. And in between, we have a moment at 2. So, we have 0, 2, and 4 as our range. If we set our percentage to 200, which is effectively doubling what we originally had, and then we click OK, moment 0 will stay the same, moment 2 will now be 4, and moment 4 will now be 8. What we've done is we've inserted time in between these moments, and we've done this by doubling the total range. So our range still starts at the first number, and because we've doubled that last number, any point in between will now shift accordingly. The final button in this section is called Merge. If you click on it, you'll get the Merge Moments window and only two text fields, which is From Moment, Till Moment. Quite simply, just choose your range, and everything within that range will be merged down to the first step in that range. Below all of this, you'll find a button for Show Information. Simply, it's just a plain text file with very simple information about this timeline. And below that, you'll have the button for OK, which when clicked on, will save your timeline and close the window.